Good day, fellas. I hope you are ready for your daily dose of skill. And today, fellas, like I mentioned in the last video, we are going to play with a badger. And before saying anything about this tank, there is two options. The games will go very well or the games will be trash. Now, listen me out why. But skill the badger, have the best firepower, amazing firepower. The DPM is 4,200 with your equipment. Very, very good. Listen. The badger is not flexible tank. Badger can have either amazing battles or either shitty games. At least that's what I noticed. This is the average stats which I have with this vehicle. The maximum, the best performance was like 8,000, but oh boys, this tank is quite ugly. And you're not seeing too many of them in the battlefield, although it has pretty much the best gun stats in the whole game. But the most important reason why you're not seeing that, it's not flexible. Yes, it can work in certain situations when you are hold down, when you are using your gun depression, when the sun is shining from the left and the rain is running on the enemies because they're making mistakes. Oh, very, very good, amazing tank. But now look, if the situation is not so good, if you are on the flat ground, every single enemy tank will say, but you have DPM skill. I believe majority of the people would agree with my thoughts about this vehicle. Or if you disagree, feel free to say in the comment section down below, skill, you are an idiot. It's okay, you can do that. At least that's what I think about this vehicle. And speaking about the Badger, and probably the direct competitor for the Badger would be E3, because both of them have a lot of armor. You know, both of them is super duper hyper turbo armored, super tank destroyers, blah blah blah, whatever. The thing is, the Badger is simply not flexible, and not much what you can do about that. In E3, I would say the situation with E3 is completely different because the armor is completely different on that tank. It's more trollish. With a Badger, it's more casual, but once again, better DPM, alpha damage, 400, and so on. 480, sorry. So, once again, everything is depending on you, but I would say this tank is not created for pressure. Now, let's think about this. If we are talking about this this situation, can we go aggressively? No, we can't. We could sit over there and wait until the enemy mistakes, or we could sit here and simply wait. Just give a time enemies to go more deeply in, and then we will craft some kind of angles and we will figure out what do we want to do. For example, this guy over there, he is making some kind of mistake and we are punishing him for his stupidity. Someone is asking who I am. Uno momento. I'm Baboon. I'm not lying, okay? I am not lying, so please. So, what is happening right there, guys? We just want to be kind of passive and kind of patient right there. As you can see, enemy team is going more aggressively into the city right there, which is not necessarily bad. Now look, if I will go and make a bit of pressure for the enemies which is playing right there, can I craft the angle for this guy over there soon? Now, yeah, I could hit him, but unfortunately I did not manage it to do that. It's okay. The Sheridan might peak like this very, very soon. Wait for it. Still wait for it. There is a big chance this guy will peak like this eventually, right? And that's what I am currently waiting for. I'm hoping for him to do some kind of mistake. Our Sheridan is using the derp gun, which is not very bueno. He did not manage to penetrate the enemy Sheridan right there because of the spaced armor and so on. It's okay. If I will move aggressively like this, the worst thing of all this will be that Sheridan will have the angle on us. What our T-57 is doing, I have no bloody clue, okay? I have no bloody clue. It's okay. How about that? We are going to check out how the sunshine is looking right there. So we are peeking like this, and yes, yes, yes. The Sheridan is right there. See? Well, what can we do in this kind of situation? Not much. But you know what? I need to craft the angle to shit on the enemy forces which is playing over there, okay? It's very, very important for us. So let's start doing the bad things for the enemies. Too bad I can't find the right angle to penetrate this guy over there, which is very, very sad, but it's 100% truth. Can I load high explosive? Sure I can. Do I want to do that? Big question. Answer is no. Hitting the Fava in his face just like this, and right there more likely I will take one for the team. Taking one for the team, in my opinion, was not so bad option, because we hit this guy once again, and now hopefully we can get more use of all this. Okay, what kind of situation we have here? We can penetrate him into the frontal mantlet just like this. It's not easy, but it's very, very possible to do so, okay? But first of all, I need to hit him, and this is, once again, this is not very easy, but everything is possible, my friends. Uno momento, crafting the angle, I could load high explosives, and I could simply cock on him. Do I want to do that? Question mark, question mark, question mark. Answer is yes, I need to do this. I need to annoy this guy, fellas. I need to annoy this guy, unfortunately. The thing is, the Fava is going very aggressively, and he shot my gun, but he suicided right there. Excellent. So far, so good. And pay attention what is happening right there. The Leo and the Patton is building the angle for themselves to start cheating on us, which is not a very good thing. So it's no bueno. Pir, going back. This battle is not ideal for this vehicle for obvious reasons. To play hold down right here is relatively hard. To not have the gun depression, well, not gun depression, but turret in the city map, ay, is also not very good. But hopefully, fellas, I hope for the best, and I want to see the enemies doing one or another stupidity. Maybe this Jack Pizda will do something stupid. I would love to see his side, then I would nyum, eat this guy. But once again, if everything would be that easy, how about this? If we would go like this, Jack Pizda just shot, right? So I assume we have time to move all the way around, and we have time to hit him once or twice. That's what I want to see, okay? Going like this, going like this, going like this, going like this, and obviously I cannot push the this corpse right there, which is kind of sad. Jack Pizda might have the shot on us, obviously the flat ground, and he have the shot on us. Quite disgusting thing, but what can you do? And this is the situation where you are noticing this tank is sucking a massive D. It's not flexible tank, okay? It is the tank with which you need to pretty much sit hold down and wait until the enemies are going to make a mistake. But skill! There is no but skill, fellas. This tank is... why you are not seeing too many of this vehicle in the battlefield? Because it's garbage. I'm not joking right here. This vehicle, although it has the best DPM in the world of tanks, yada, it's not good vehicle in the current game meta. It's just not good tank, guys. It's not good tank. And I would love to say something like, well, but, no but, just no but. What do we want to do now? We will try to build some kind of hold down over there. Maybe it will work, maybe we will get one or another extra shot right there, but that's it. It's not going to be epic, let's say like that. It is not going to be epic. And I am dead in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Epic ending.
epic ending, okay? That was nice. Okay, at least we got like 500 extra damage from that guy, which was good. Okay, so what is happening with this vehicle? This tank is not... I know I'm saying the same thing, but it's not flexible vehicle, okay? Or maybe I am that bad dancer which don't know how to play with that vehicle. One or another way, I'm feeling good with this battle, 3,400. It was not that bad as I was expecting to, but it was not the sunshine and the rainbows from the unicorn ass, okay? It was not that good, but anyways, I had quite some fun. Oh my bananas. Obviously, I will read the messages after the video. And yes, I am answering into the messages when I'm receiving that in game, but obviously it's taking quite some time because usually currently I'm playing in the Ru server and I'm having quite a big blast while doing so, although the tanks with which we are playing right here is definitely not, you know, super good or super awesome or whatever. I have the IS-2 in the Ru server and I should record couple of battles with that vehicle because I don't have any highlights, although there was couple of games when I got like over 4,000 damage or something, but let's say like that tank is such a big RNG fiesta, it's crazy how disgusting that vehicle is. Anyways, it's not about that tank. What do we want to do, fellas? We want to focus on the gameplay with a Badger and Kempinovka with two artists. Now, let's think about it. What is happening right there? Can we go super aggressively on top of the hill? Sure we can. What we can expect, now imagine when you are playing with a slow and not very flexible tank, what might happen? You are going on top of the hill, peer, 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 you are taking the hill, life is beautiful, there's sunshine everywhere, and Arta. And then Arta. And then Arta. And you know what, Arta? Yeah, it's not going to be Gucci, but I will go on the hill. I mean, obviously I could snipe from the back from somewhere over there, but I am not sure should I do this or not, to be honest. I mean, there is quite some forces, there's quite some enemy forces over there, so maybe it would not be. By the way, let's make this Arta move. Oh. I used to love to do this in the front lines when you are hitting your own Arta. Obviously you are not doing damage by any means, but then Arta is going on the full panic mode and Arta is running and so on, so on. Too bad I did not manage to do that in the randoms. Well, at least I tried, okay? At least I tried. Anyways, what we are doing, blah, 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 going on top of the hill, and hopefully the performance is going to be good. Although I am kind of a weird of that artist is going to shit on us, and more likely I'm going to forget my name. But we'll see. We'll see how the things will go. Speaking, what kind of other options do we have with this vehicle? We can snipe from the back. Is it the best thing to do? More likely not, but hey. My ass is unpenetrable. GG. I'm feeling so much better after saying that. I'm feeling so much better after saying that, guys. You know what we are going to do? First of all, I think we are going to deal with this guy over there, okay? With this light tank, which is more likely sitting in the bush already. How we are going to check it out? We are going like this and we are crafting angle. Definitely not a direct hit. That's sad, but it's true. Let's see. Can we punish this person over there or we cannot punish him? Trying to find the angle. Definitely not a diary hit. It's okay, we have all time in the world of tanks. Another hit right here because it's important. And the last but not least hit over there. Then we will go help our hill. I did not manage to find the shot, so maybe this person did not took the hill. Okay, he did not took this position, that's what I meant to say. You see how many forces we have on the hill? We have so many forces, it's crazy. So I think I can afford to take the bottom part of the... Of this Kempinovka hill over there, and hopefully we will have a good angles to shit on the guys which is playing around this area. Now it's time to go with the blind shots. Why so? Because we can. So we are aiming like this and we are checking, are we hitting someone? I don't really think that was a hit, but you know, you never know. Why not to go for another one? Another, definitely not a hit, and STB is trying to run. Since STB is trying to run, I would love to punish him like this. That was not the best shot from my side, but hey, what can you do? Nothing. The E50M is sitting in some kind of shithole right here, and now we can use our DPM. Well, kind of. We can kind of start using our DPM because this guy is dead meat already. Okay, how about this EBR-90? Can we find the shots into this guy? Let's see. Unfortunately, this is not a hit, which is very, very sad thing, but at least we tried. We are trying to find the angle. Not, it's not the hit. Let's go for another one like this. And if this person is sitting in the bush, we should cover him already, but unfortunately, we did not hit, manage to hit anything. What we are doing now, going like this. Oh my bananas, look at that sneaky boy. I shot this position from the left to the right, from the right to the left, and so on, and I did not manage to craft the good angle. Well, what can you do? Mistakes which I did in this battle, I was not playing too aggressively over there. I needed to be more aggressive, and instead of trying to blind fire this guy over there, I needed to go on top of the hill, and more likely I would have couple of free shots in this kind of situation. Since that was not the case, what can I do? Nothing. Now this guy is saying blah, 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 blah. And luckily we kind of managed to outplay him right there. So just because of us, he decided to go in front like a special guy, and it is okay. Now what do we want to do? The Waffelcock is sitting in those bushes over there, okay? He is right there. I am 100% certain about it. So whenever he is going to get spotted, more likely we are going to smack him in the face once, twice, or three times, how many times we want, it's okay. Obviously, I think I kind of need to move more aggressive right here. Waffelcock is getting spotted and... Oh, I am missing my shot. Ooh, I hate the badger. So, fellas, I mean, I want to be bloody honest with you, okay? Badger is the tank which have amazing DPM, okay? The DPM is amazing on this vehicle, but in order to have a good battle with this vehicle, you need to be lucky as fucking fuck, okay? So, do I recommend to grind this tank or something? No, I don't. But skill the DPM! Fellas, DPM in the world of tanks is not everything. The way more important thing is flexibility. If the tank is not flexible, even though it has amazing DPM, usually the tank is not very good. Once again, it's only me, it is only my opinion about it, but that's what I think, my friends, and that's why I'm sharing that with you. Speaking about the flexibility, at least of the Badger, I mean, F me backwards, fellas, but I don't think this tank is flexible at all, and I don't really think this tank is amazing. But once again, it could be my fault, it could be just because I am not playing well with this vehicle, and I am not afraid to say that I'm not playing well with this vehicle for sure, so, you know. By the way, quite funny thing, I believe you noticed that this person did not manage to penetrate us with high explosives in the face. I mean, literally zero damage dealt right there. I'm going kind
kind of aggressively like this. Obviously, I'm missing my shot, and the STB is sniping us from the back, which is kind of bad thing, but not much what I can change right there. There is a guy over there, I believe you know that, and you noticed that. I'm trying to hit the shots, I'm not hitting shit. And the aim time is not horrible of this vehicle, you can be sure about that, but it is just happening. Arta is getting spotted, aiming fully, hitting the ground. Oh my, bananas from Banana Farm. Ooh. I mean, this is the game which I want to show you with this vehicle, okay? You, in order to get, like, very, very good battle with the tanks, which is extremely specific as Badger is, the most important part for your success is luck. Because you need to be lucky to take the certain position. You need to be lucky to hit the certain shots. And so on, so on, so on. I would love to say something more. I would love to share. I would love to show you more and so on, but it's just not the case, okay? I have a question for you, fellas. Am I only one who thinks the Badger is actually disgusting tank, as a tank? Or you think the same thing right here? I'm just curious, okay? I am very, very curious with that, fellas. Maybe I am only one who have this kind of problems. And maybe you think, I don't know how to play with this tank, which could be completely possible, fellas. Because once again, let's say like that, the Badger and the slow tanks like this is definitely not my strong side. For heavy tank players, maybe this vehicle would perform better, but for me it's just not the case. So please leave your thoughts in the comment section down below. I'm very, very curious, what do you think about this vehicle in general? So what happened right there? I tried to do as much as I could. 1,400 damage, by the way, 24 shots, 10 hits, 3 penetrations. Speaking of average performance with this vehicle, my friends, 2,400 damage, which is like twice more than DPM. You know what? I'm not going to give up yet. Let's fight for our victory, okay? Let's fight for it. One more battle. I hope and I want to believe we are going to be lucky. If not, you will see 3 garbage games. If yes, then at least one of the battles is going to be, let's say like that, just tiny touch better. By the way, for tomorrow's video, you are going to see some kind of recorded footage. I have shit on of the replays. I have some Progetto games. So maybe you will see some Progetto T8. I have the 140 battle. I have Gusor and MTV, the third mark games more likely. I have a lot of stuff, but probably Progetto is going to be the one, because I have many of those, so why not to share that with you, my friends? I am just updating you if you are following the daily content, so you will see everything yourself. Anyways, what is happening right there? What the flying F is this much making? 50B, 50B, 50B. And we have a lot of heavy tanks. I mean, it's not necessarily bad, because 50B, what 50B can do, if the 50B will go over there, they will get F'd by the artists and it's going to be bad. I could go over there, but I'm not going to do that. You know why? Because I think it's going to be more useful to go like this, although we might get farmed by the enemy artists quite a bit. If you are wondering, is this tank can be penetrated by artists? Yes, if Artis is hitting the engine deck, if I remember that correctly, I was getting penetrated for 1,000 or so. So keep this in mind. Anyways, I think it's simply going to be better. Obviously, maybe going like this could work too, to take this whole down position or sit over there. I'm not up for that. I think going like this, pushing like this might be better. And I don't really think and I don't really want to play with this vehicle as a bush wanker tank destroyer, which can't do anything else, just wank in the bush. Once again, maybe it is my fault, but that's how I prefer to play the game, and sometimes the things is going very, very well, and sometimes the things is not going that well. What is happening right there? The Bobject is pushing in front, the IS-7 is pushing in front, the 705A is pushing in front, and now I'm kind of regretting by not going over there, because I would be in this position already, and I could probably already start thinking about farming those guys over there, but it is how it is. No complaints. Okay. So what is happening right here? As you can see, our team is already making a hardcore pressure like this. So it's not necessarily bad for us. Why so? Because we can start crafting the angles into the people which is sitting over there. And you know what? I'm pretty sure they will have someone which is sitting on this corner, okay? I'm pretty sure about that, so why not to go with one blind shot over there? And maybe we could punish this RHM Panzerwagen or Flipwagen, which is running like this, and we are trying to punish him just like he's already dead. Well, what can you do? I don't really think Progetto is sitting over there anymore, and what enemy 50Bs are doing, as expected, they are sniping from the back somewhere. They are not making any pressure whatsoever, but in the same time, it is completely understandable, because 50B is not very, very, it's not created tank for pressure. So, obviously, I mean, thinking about the situation, we have Heavis, they have the 50Bs, in the open map where there is Artas, who is winning the battle? 50Bs, obviously. Now, fellas, I'm messing with you. Obviously not 50Bs. They don't have the potential right there, and to play with 50B, it's very, very hard. And let's start from the bottom. And the most important thing, this should not be in matchmaking. Like 50Bs matched against the Mouse 705A 260 or something. This is just not how the things should go. Let's say like that. But once again, it is how it is. No complaints, no regrets. Not much what we can simply change right there. Slowly but surely we are getting closer to the enemies, and oh boy, there is still a lot of things for us to do. There is still a lot of hit points, and as wrong as it sounds, we can get a lot of use of all this. This 50B is more likely sitting next to this house over there, right? So I am kind of going into some kind of crossfire right there. But what I want to do, I want to deal with this TVP, because he is amazing. He's a huge pain in the ass for our team. Let's say like that. Okay? It's very, very important. Now, I want to hit this 50B once. Right? And if this TVP will try to go on us, I will notice that in time, more likely, at least I hope so. The 50B is getting spotted, and I'm claiming his life with a big smile on my face. Plus, on top of that, this TVP is pretty much dead meat, dead cookie. He can't do shit right there, okay? So what we are going to do, we are going to eliminate this guy from the game. The TVP is saying, I'm clipping someone. Yeah, you can clip whatever you want. And now we are going to go with high explosives. Hashtag believe in the YouTube comment section, boys, and we are going for it. You know what we are going for? Hi, Beast 600 in the face, my lovely friend. I love you. You are my favorite cookie. Beast 300 in the face. How dare you to not get penetrated? I'm just going aggressively for this guy. I really want to eat him for breakfast. Okay. We are going. He's not very happy, but he should be not happy. And we are hitting him once. What the flying F? I hit his gun. You mother trucker, how dare you? Beast! Now 660 like a boss. And we are having the horsepower right there. Beast! He is so smart. Okay, I need to give some kudos for this guy. The most important thing, why? Because he is sticking his gun into my gun, okay? So what is happening right here? He actually... Please, RNG, bless the shot and let me... Beautiful. So what this guy did, he sticked his gun into my gun, and I'm doing that too from time to time, right? So what happened right here, he actually made me to splash myself. That was 200 IQ, and I need to give some kudos for that guy. That was actually amazing. Anyways, this guy is dead. Hip hip hooray. Solid 4000 skill. Why 4000? The answer is very, very simple. We have one blind shot into the progetto. How do I know that? I knew it, because when I saw the progetto spotted last time, he had 1.5 or 1.4 thousand hit points. That's why I knew we hit him. Anyways, it was okay, at least the nice finishing with this vehicle, and it's fine. Also, for some people who did not understood what happened with this Fava did everything properly, okay? This Fava did everything well. So when this is the situation, when we are playing face to face, what he did, he sticked his long boomstick into the badger's gun, and when high explosive is leaving the barrel, it's going like this and it's getting stopped by the enemy gun, okay? So I'm splashing myself. That was 200 IQ strategy, and that guy played well, okay? I'm surprised. That was extremely good game by that guy, and he played very, very well. I didn't though, but it's okay, I'm accepting that. So badger, 3 battles, the last game was the best. Those first two was not that good, but hey, 3000 average damage, 1.1 average assisting damage, not that bad for a couple of battles, and I am simply accepting that, fellas. So, fellas, thank you so much for watching your daily dose of skill. I hope you had quite some fun. The other game is going to, the other video is going to be with Progetto and something else. So see you tomorrow, and thank you so much for your time. I hope you learned something new. I hope I kept a company for you, and I hope you enjoyed your morning or evening coffee. Thank you, and see you next time, fellas. Peace.